Hi, welcome to the second part of the Inspector UiCap tutorial series. My name is Nils and I work as an application engineer here at SICK, and I'm the developer of this UiPlus plugin. Today I will show you how to switch reference objects from the robot program. I will also show you how to use the blob tool to locate this object instead of the object locator tool we used in the first tutorial to locate this object. If you haven't seen the first tutorial, that shows you how to configure the SICK Inspector PIM 60 and create a simple vision-guided pick-and-place robot application, please do so by following the link in the description below. We will start this tutorial by connecting to our SICK Inspector PIM 60 from SOPAS and create a new reference object. Okay, so we're now connected to the inspector in SOPAS, and we can start by putting the inspector in edit mode. We then add a new reference object. Next thing is to teach this new reference object, and we place it in front of the camera and press the teach reference object button. Now we choose the blob tool and mark the area we're interested in locating the object. As you can see, the inspector calculates some predefined values for us, and we can see in the live image if this works for us to locate our object. And it looks like in this case it's working just fine. We can now continue to set up our Ethernet output string the same way we did in the first tutorial. In the first tutorial we used the object locator tool and put in that tag in the Ethernet output string. Then we had our decision flag, our X coordinate, our Y coordinate, our Z coordinate, and our rotation. We're gonna do the same for the blob tool. First, we have to set the angle type to radians, our unit to millimeters, and check that we have aligned coordinates. We then choose the blob tool. In this case, we are only interested in the first blob that the inspector finds, so we will remove the index. Then we insert the decision flag. Our X, Y, and Z coordinate, and finally our rotation, which for the blob tool is called angle. We then need the comma and the space tag. And we can copy this to sit between the others. And finally, we need parentheses around the whole expression. We can now validate that our output string looks fine. And it seems to do. So we can apply this, press the OK button, and finally put the camera in run mode and save our settings to flash. We will continue to edit the program from the first tutorial. We can first go in and check in our SICK Inspector installation node. Click on the refresh button and see that we have our second reference object. I put it in trigger mode. So what we do here is that we are first looking for object one. We then have to go to the advanced tab and set a timeout for this object. So we can set this to 0.5 seconds. After you run the program the first time, you can go in under variables and see that you have a variable that is called sick obj located, and in this case it's 1. We can use this variable to see if our object was located or not. But first we have to define this. So we add a before start sequence, we add a assignment node, we rename our variable to sick underscore obj located and assign this to 0. We can now use this in the robot program. So after the first move to campus node, we can add a if statement. And in here, we can look at our sick obj located to see if this is 0 or not. So if this is 1, it means that we have located our object, and we can continue to pick this up and drop it off in one location. So I will just cut and paste this into our if statement. Though if the sick obj located flag is 0, it means that we haven't found this object and we want to look for the other object. So we can add else statement. In the else statement, we can then add another move to campus node. First, we need to adjust the gripper a little bit for this object. So we set the gripping width to 50 millimeters. And go back to the Eurocaps tab and insert our move to campus node. And in here we select the second object. So we need to teach the pick position of this object to the robot. We place our gripper above the object in the way we want to grip it. And click the set pose button. And we can see that the offsets are calculated for us. We now have to add a few other nodes. So we will grip the object while we're above it. So we set the gripping width to 20 millimeters. We can copy the relative waypoint we used for the first object. So we copy this, paste it in, and then we need to move to drop it off at another location. So maybe we can use this place here, add another waypoint, set this point, and okay. And finally, we need to open the gripper. So we set it to 40 millimeters. So we have our home position. We look for the first object, the first reference object. If we find this, we pick it up. If we don't find it, we go into the else statement and try to locate our second reference object. So we can start by placing this in front of the inspector and try our program. And place the other reference object. Place the first one again. And the second one once more. You now have an overview on how to switch reference objects with the Inspector Viewer cap. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure to subscribe to the SICK YouTube channel and also watch the other parts in the Inspector Viewer cap tutorial series.